Honorable President of India, Shri Ramnath Kovind ji, Honorable Governor of Uttar Pradesh, Shri Ramnath, Honorable Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, Shri Yogi Adityanath ji, Honorable Deputy Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, Dr. Dinesh Sharma ji, President of Vigyan Bharati, Dr. Vijay Bhatkal ji, Dr. Renu Swarup ji, Dr. Ashutosh Sharma ji, Dr. Rajivan ji, all the very senior and distinguished guests present in this August gathering, our scientists, our research scholars, our dear students, and friends from the media. Friends, it's a very, very happy occasion for me as Science and Technology Minister of India to be welcoming you at the function which is the opening function of the India International Science Festival 2018, the fourth one in succession over the last 4 years. Before I say something about this event, I would like to thank all of you, all the scientists, and more particularly the young students, whom I saw that they traveled long distances, covering thousands of kilometers, traveling in trains for 2 days, 3 days, and coming from even the remotest villages of India, and happily, enthusiastically participating in this India International Science Festival for the last 2 days. I extend a special welcome to all the young children. Children, I wish to inform you that this India International Science Festival 2018 is dedicated to the memory of one of the greatest statesmen of India, one of the greatest human beings that we have seen in politics, our revered Shri Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji, the former Prime Minister of India, whom we all have always and will continue to love and respect and adore from the deepest core of our heart. I pay my most humble tributes to his memory today, because we have dedicated this science festival to him and his memory and his blessings. We all know that he is the man who brought science to the central stage of Indian politics, when as Indian Prime Minister, he did so much for science, and we can never forget his contribution to India that he made on the 11th of May 1998 and brought us into the league of those great nations of the whole world. And he is the one who said that it has to be not only Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan, but it has also to be Jai Vigyan. And we are also fortunate that we have today another Prime Minister who enjoys the legacy of that great Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee, and who is equally passionate about science, who has extreme confidence in the ability of the scientists, and especially who feels that the young people, the young students, their abilities have to be supported to the maximum. And that is why he has brought the startup and the stand-up mission for the young minds. Anybody out of you, anybody anywhere in India today, whether he is formally educated or not, whether he has a science background or not, but if he has an idea in his mind, and if he wants to convert that idea into an entrepreneurship, he wants to deliver something for the society using his idea. The whole government of Prime Minister Narendra Modi, and more particularly the Science and Technology Ministry, we stand rock solid behind you to ensure that your dreams are realized and your ambitions are taken care of. I would like to use this occasion to thank the scientific community of India, because today, I think in the last 70 years, science in India has reached a level where we can compare our progress, our achievements to anything happening at the best level anywhere in the world. I don't say that because of any emotion, because I am a science and technology minister. I say that because the data, because the rankings, and not the Indian rankings, but the international rankings about the progress of science made under the leadership of our great leader Narendra Modi ji today, with the blessings of our honorable president, they speak volumes about our achievement. To give you just a glance of that, today our scientific publications in India, they rank at 6th position in the whole world, and I think in the next science festival you will find this ranking has also improved to 5th or 4th. Our growth rate in scientific publications is 14%, but the international growth rate is just about 4%. Nanotechnology, a recent development of science, we rank 3rd in the whole world. A country which was caught unaware, struck by a tsunami in 2004, lakhs of people lost their lives. Today, when I talk to you in 2018 under the leadership of Prime Minister Modi, our early warning systems for tsunami, we rank at number one in the whole world. And we give warnings to all the rim countries. If I talk to you about weather forecasting, cyclones, ocean studies, etc., etc., we have a 10 petaflop capability of high performance computing, and we rank at 4th number in the whole world. Dr. Bhatkar was talking about CSIR now. CSIR is our most prestigious organization, which was born in 1942. It has 38 labs all over the country, and the CSIR scientists, they develop new research, new technologies, they deliver them through the industry to the people of India and try to alleviate the sufferings of people of India through those technologies. In recent years, only the last 4 years, they have already delivered over 800 technologies to the people of India, and the whole science and technology department must have developed at least 5,000 technologies. And if we make a list of all such institutions like CSIR all over the world, which are funded by government, and the government supports them for research, the list is 1,207. You will find it hard to believe that today, as per the International Shimago ranking, CSIR ranks at a position 9th in the whole world. If I talk of biotechnology, vaccine manufacturing, vaccine development issues, we, you know, Prime Minister, under Prime Minister Modi's leadership, we gave to the country rotavirus in the National Immunization Program. Today, we are the biggest manufacturer of vaccine in the whole world. Every third child in the whole world who gets a vaccine for anything, that is made by India. And similarly for biosimilars, we are 3rd in the whole world now, and very soon you will hear that we have become probably number one in the whole world. It's just about, and it's not only these datas, whether it is fundamental science, whether it is genomics, whether it is solution science, whether it is translational science, whether it is talking about artificial intelligence, whether it is cyber physical security systems, or whether it is about space. We all know that under Narendra Modi ji's leadership, we got the Mars orbiter mission successful in the first attempt, the only country in the whole world where we got the Mars orbiter mission successful in the first attempt. We now have a world record of sending 104 satellites in space in one single go. Today, the same America which used to say once that they will not give visa to our Prime Minister Narendra Modi, they now request us. They want our carrier to be used for the launching of the American satellites. That is the progress that we have made in science. Friends, this is not the time, because the time that has been given to me is just about 5 minutes. And we are very eagerly waiting for our Honorable Prime Minister, President, to give us his blessings. I'll not go into the details of all these things, but I can appeal and use this forum to become party to the realization of the dreams of our Prime Minister Narendra Modi. He has dreamt of a new India by 2022. And he strongly feels that if the scientific community takes care of its scientific social responsibility, if we diagnose the problems of the people, and if we direct our strategies towards the people of India, we make them people-centric, diagnose the problems. After having worked with science and technology for 4 years, I am confident that science has the potential and the capability and the power to solve each and every problem of India which the people of India continue to face for the last 70 years. The only key to that is that we have to come out of slumber, if at all we are, but I think we have already shed the slumber. We are already working out of the box. Our innovation coefficient is being used amply by our people. 5,000 startups have been supported by this government in the last 4 years. And every now and then we see young people coming out with great innovations. I would like all of you to go back from here. All the students, all the innovators, all the young, all the women scientists, all our students who have come from Northeast, all our teachers, and all the science lovers who have come to this India International Science Festival, go back from here with a dream, with a positive dream. We have to ensure that we are also a party to the realization of the dreams of our Prime Minister Narendra Modi, because he has utmost confidence in the ability of our younger people, and more particularly our students, who are our future Kalams, who are our future C.V. Ramans, who are our future Ramanujams. And I don't see young students here. I see future great scientists of India here. And I'm sure that Prime Minister wants that by 2030, he wants us to be amongst the top three scientific nations of the whole world. I can very clearly and very distinctly see that we have the ability to achieve that. We shall be able to achieve that. We have right now collaborations with more than 80 countries of the whole world. I sat across the table in White House also with the scientists of America, with scientists of Israel, with scientists of South Korea, or with the Australians, or with English scientists, German scientists, French scientists. Nowhere ever in the whole world we have felt that the capabilities of our scientists in India are inferior to them in any aspect. We discuss with them, we share our experiences with them, and we have devised a lot of schemes for our young scientists, for our young students. Shall not discuss here, but the 4 days, if you spend your time very meticulously in this India International Science Festival, you will know everything about what is happening in science in India and all across the world. And I am sure that when you go back from here, you will feel really proud of the scientific accomplishments of all our Indian counterparts. Thank you so much. Namaskar. Jai Hind. Bharat Mata Ki Jai.